Hello guys, in this particular video we will learn some AC analysis concepts for not single stage but multi-stage amplifier using filled effect transistor, that is FET. In this particular video we will start with a simple mode of filled effect transistor, that is CS mode, that is common source mode. So if we are saying that the CS means common source is one input stage and common source is another output stage, that forms your two stage amplifier formed by two transistors of FET. So let's discuss about AC analysis of FET using CS mode. Okay guys, we have this particular circuit. In this particular circuit we have first stage which comprises of R1, R2, RD2, RS2, D for drain, S for source, and this middle one is nothing but N-channel filled effect transistor, more specifically N-channel junction filled effect transistor. So this is of first stage. I can say that it's nothing but the input stage. Input will be is given at the gate side of filled effect transistor. So maybe instead of input we'll be having input source resistance and then we'll be giving the input, so it will be more preferable for practical scenario, right? So here we will say our signal, right, this is R2 R1 CS2, this is your, that forms your input stage. And second is your output stage, whereas this complete stage will give you the idea about how much output I'm getting from the first stage, right? So by using the input of first stage, how much output I'm getting, so that gives you the enhanced output, because already by using first stage your input is amplified, and that amplified input for the first stage will act as input for your second stage. So I can say that here whatever output I'm getting, that will be more strengthened than that of your output of first stage, because this is a cascade nature. So stage 2 is called as output stage, right? So we have to do the basic AC analysis, right? So before jumping directly into AC analysis, we will learn some logics behind this particular AC analysis. So before starting with AC analysis, we will start the step number 1, that will be your DC analysis, right? So step number A, I can say this will be your DC analysis. Okay, whenever we are learning for the DC analysis, DC means direct current. So we are just checking how much DC voltage is applied, so that I'm getting the particular reference point, particular Q point, right, which is based on the required one. Okay, okay. So before jumping into the directly AC analysis, we will first start with the DC analysis. So let us discuss about the DC analysis. So whenever we are starting with the DC analysis, we have to say that frequency is equal to 0. If frequency is equal to 0, all the capacitive reactances of coupling capacitors will become infinity. So I have to keep it as open circuit. So we have to open all the coupling and bypass capacitor which are connected externally. So I can say that this CC1, CC2, CS1, CS2, CC3, all the capacitances will become open. Now strange is, if CC2 is open, input stage has nothing to do with the output stage. So input stage and output stage will be independent of each other as far as simple DC analysis is concerned. Okay, so we will draw simple input stage and output stage independently, and we can find out what are the Q parameters independently. So first of all, we will draw particular input stage independently. As far as JFET is concerned, this is your first circuit, which is of stage number 1. Okay, For second stage, we'll be having another circuit. Independently, we can easily calculate the values of Q parameters that are nothing but connected to ground. This is your RS2, this is R3, this is R4, this is R3, and this is RD2 connected to positive DC source. Okay. Now, as far as this simple connections are concerned, we just have to calculate the Q parameters. So, my duty in the DC analysis is to calculate Q parameters. Okay, Q parameters are nothing but there will be two Q parameters, separate Q parameters for stage 1, separate Q parameters for stage 2. If all the resistance values R1, R2, RD1, RS1 and VDD are same for stage 1 and stage 2, your Q parameters will be same, obviously. So, we will say, see to it that we will be having Q parameters as VGS1Q, then ID1Q, then VDS1Q. Okay, so all these are nothing but the stage 1 Q parameter. So we'll be getting stage 1 Q parameter from this particular circuit. Stage 2 Q parameter are nothing but VGS2Q, ID2Q, VDS2Q. Okay, these are nothing but the stage 2 Q parameters. Now, how to get these Q parameters? We already have learned from the DC analysis. I'll just in brief will tell you. We have to just convert, first step, we'll have to just convert into Thevenin's theorem, apply the input KVL. From the input KVL, we'll get particular value of VGS, which is of the function of ID. We'll have to put that value of VGS as a function of ID into the equation of ID is equal to ID is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP the whole square. Then we will get the quadratic equation. From the quadratic equation, we will be getting the value of ID and VGS. From that VGS and ID values, we will just apply the output KVL and we will be getting the value of VDSQ. Okay. So, this is how we will have to do the DC analysis. Once we get the value of the DC parameters, that are nothing but the Q parameters, we will have to move towards the another parameter which is very, very important for AC point of view, AC analysis point of view. Okay, so we'll go towards the intermediate stage of the in between the AC and DC analysis. So we'll say that step number 2B is nothing but the calculation of GM, right? Calculation of GM. Once we know the value of, we'll say, known values from DC analysis. What we'll have to calculate from DC analysis? We just have to know the value of VGS and ID from DC analysis to find out the value of GM. Okay. So what will be the formula for GM? GM is nothing but GMO multiplied by 1 minus VGS divided by VP. That is the perfect formula for GM. GM is called as a transconductance. Okay. So, GMO, where I can say that GMO is equal to 2 into IDSS divided by mod of VP. Okay. So, once we know the value of IDSS, once we know the value of VP, we can easily calculate the value of GMO. But for VGS, we have to go for the DC analysis. So, once we get the value of VGS, we can easily calculate what is the value of GM. And GM is very important parameter as far as AC analysis using RPI model is concerned. So, without which I cannot determine what will be the voltage gain, what will be the current gain. Other current gain is not important for FET perspective. So, for voltage gain, GM is very, very important. Okay. So, this is how we have to calculate the GM. If stage 1, now very much important part we have to consider that if stage 1 few parameters. Are different than that of stage 2. What does it mean? For suppose stage 1 ke liye ID is 2 milliampere and stage 2 ke liye ID is 4 milliampere. That means that for your stage 1, whatever value of VGS you will be getting, that will be different than that of stage 2. So ultimately, the value of GM will not be same. So ultimately, conclusion will be, if stage 1 Q parameters are different than that of stage 2, I will be getting GM1 and GM2 will be different for stage 1 and 2, right? So GM1 will be for stage 1 and GM2 will be for stage 2, right? So while calculating the particular voltage gain, we have to make sure that which GM we are considering for calculating the voltage gain. So this is how we have to calculate the value of GM. Next, we will proceed further for our exact topic, that is nothing but your AC analysis. So for that, we have to move forward for the AC equivalent model. So AC equivalent model we will first draw, and then we will try to find out what will be the voltage gain, how to calculate the input resistance, and how to calculate the output resistance. Okay, so first of all, this is our circuit. This is our circuit, right? And now we have to consider this particular JFET into another equivalent model, that is RPi model. This another JFET, let's say this is J1 and this is J2. So J1 I will first convert into AC equivalent using RPi model. AC equivalent model using RPi. So we will first draw, as your gate current is very, very low, that is nothing but zero, I can say that input resistance is very, very high. It means that infinity. So I can say this is nothing but the infinite input impedance represented at the input side. I can say VGS1, right? Then I can say this is your dependent current source, and whose value is GM1 multiplied by VGS1. VGS you can turn into VPi1 as well, right? There is no harm by saying that VGS is nothing but VPi, right? So this is your AC equivalent model for first only the transistor, that is JFET. So we will say that this is nothing but your source, this is your drain side, and this is your gate side, right? So we will try to modify this particular circuit which is given for us, right? This was the circuit. We have converted this J1 into AC equivalent model, and now we have to just form this particular R1, RD2, R2, RS2 according to the terminals of JFET, right? First important fact that you have to consider while taking the AC equivalent model, AC analysis for but particular amplifier, two important things: all coupling capacitors we have to consider short circuit, and all DC sources as well we have to consider short circuit. So basically we are just giving the input without any DC source, and now we are analyzing what will be your output gain. Okay, so we will say that all coupling capacitors are short circuit, all DC sources are short circuit, and now we'll realize what will be the orientation of the resistances, placement of the resistances as far as AC analysis is concerned. Okay, so we will place this particular gate resistances. This R1 is connected with plus VDD, that means connected to ground, as DC sources are short circuited. So R1 is connected to ground, R2 is already connected to ground. Oh great, so R1 parallel R2, right? So I can say that this will form your I can say that we have short of space, we'll say this is RG1. Here I will write, what is RG1? RG1 is nothing but R1 parallel R2, right? Generally in JPEG we use self bias, but here I have considered the voltage divider bias, right? So this capacitor is then connected, right, with short circuited, replaced by short circuited, connected to the R signal. So I will connect the R signal directly to gate and then input resistance. So I can say that this will be your R signal along with the input resistance, that is VI. Okay, now we can say that this is your orientation placement of the resistances RG1 and R signal. This is the input side of the first stage. We'll try to draw the output side of the first stage and the source side of the first stage. So let's try to get that first stage source side. As CS1 is connected with short circuit, replaced with the short circuit, RS1 will become redundant, right? As RS1 will become redundant, your source is directly connected to the ground, okay? So I can say that this is directly connected to the ground. Moreover, this D is connected with drain resistance, that is RD1, and it is also connected to the ground because VDD is short circuited, right? So we will say this becomes short circuited. Next, we will proceed further for the second stage, right? So I will first again draw the AC equivalent model for J2, that is another FET, right? So we will again say that this is your open circuit configuration for the input side of stage 2. So this is your VGS2 plus minus, here is a source, here I can say the dependent current source, that is nothing but GM2 into VGS2, okay? Moreover, we can say that this is nothing but the gate side, that is gate 2, this is gate 1, D1, S1, this is gate 2, this is source 2, and this is your drain 2. Simple. So first of all, we have drawn the complete AC equivalent model for only second transistor, second stage ka transistor, okay? Now we will try to place all the resistances which are connected to the J2, okay? So see to it that your source resistance, that is nothing but connected to the source S2, right, that will be redundant as well because capacitor is placed in parallel with that, which is been short circuited for the AC analysis. So I can say that this is also been short circuited. Okay, so for this is short circuited, source side is covered. For gate side, gate is connected with R3 and R4 in parallel combination. So we will say that because R3 is connected to plus VDD, which has been short circuited, connected to ground. R4 is already connected to ground, so which forms your combined form in the form of, I can say, I will make the name as RG2. So this will become connected to the ground. I can say this RG2 is equal to R3 in parallel with R4. Okay, R3 parallel R4, this is nothing but your RG2. At the output side, I am having RD2, that is nothing but the drain resistance for the second stage. So drain resistance for the second stage is connected to the VDD and VDD is short circuited. So this is also connected to the ground. I can say that this is RD2 and here I am getting the output, that is VO, right? So this looks very beautiful circuit of AC equivalent model for two stage CSCS amplifier, right? Now this is over, drawing is over. Now question arises, what kind of parameters I have to find out, right? So parameters to find out, three parameters are very important to find out from this AC equivalent model. First is voltage gain. Second is input resistance. And third is your output resistance. Okay. So as far as these three parameters are concerned, we will again look at this particular circuit, we'll operate this particular circuit rather, we'll analyze this circuit and we will find out what will be the value of voltage gain, input impedance and input resistance and output resistance. Okay, so we will start with our five fingers. Again, I'll introduce what are the nothing but the five fingers. Five fingers are nothing but first is your KVL, second is KCL, third is Ohm's law, fourth is your CDR and fifth is your VDR. VDR is nothing but voltage divider rule, current divider rule, Ohm's law, and then KCL is nothing but Kirchhoff's current law. And then KVL is nothing but Kirchhoff's voltage law. All these five laws you should know, and then we can easily proceed further to find out what is the voltage gain. So let's further find out what, how to find out the voltage gain. Whenever we want to find out the voltage gain, we have to go from out in output side towards the input side. Okay, there are three forms of your voltage gain. Voltage gain along with the source resistance, voltage gain by the consideration of load resistance, and the voltage gain just by neglecting the source resistance. Okay, so we will try to figure out as far as the given circuit is concerned. This is our given circuit and we have to find out the value of the voltage gain. So now here we have to deal with some mathematical analysis. As we have discussed, first five fingers law we will consider for with KCL. We have to just apply KCL at this particular node, right? I'll give you two methods with which we can find out the voltage gain. So first of all, VO divided by VI is my voltage gain, right? That ratio gives you the voltage gain. Voltage gain AV is nothing but VO divided by VI. I can convert this VO divided by VI into some extent. I will slice this into two parts. One is VO divided by VO1, right? And another is VO1 divided by VI. So that I will be getting VO divided by VI. So here we can say that VO divided by VO1 dot VO1 divided by VI. Ultimately, we will be getting the same. But here I am splitting the complete gain into two independent voltage gain for each stage, right? So here I can say that this is nothing but voltage gain for first stage, and here it is nothing but the voltage gain for second stage, right? So it's up to your wish that we can take AV1 first, calculate AV1, then calculate AV2, then their product will be nothing but your value of voltage gain, combined voltage gain for two stage CSCS amplifier. Okay, so instead of doing that, I will go with the conventional method to find out the value of voltage gain. That is nothing but the applying KCL at this particular node. Apply KCL at this particular node, we'll get to know that there are only two branches. One is going towards the RD2 and one is going towards the current source, that is GM2, VGS2. Okay, so we will first say that apply KCL at node A. Okay, so we will give the name namakaran for this particular node as node number A. So for node A, we will find out this is nothing but the output current, right? This output current is nothing but GM2 VGS2, and this output current is nothing but the, by using Ohm's law, VO divided by RD2. Okay, so here I can say that only two output currents are available, input currents are not there. So output current is equal to input current. I can say that this will become your GM2 VGS2 plus VO divided by RD2 is equal to 0. This, from this particular equation, we will be get to know that VO and VGS2 ka ratio. I can say that VO divided by VGS2 will become minus GM2 multiplied by RD2, and that is nothing but equation number 1. Now one more fact you have to understand, that if RL, that is RL is given, load resistance is given, if RL is given, right, then we have to consider RD2 parallel with RL. Okay, if RL is given, you have to consider RD2 parallel with RL instead of RD2. Okay, so GM2 will be there. So this is your equation number 1. Now I reach towards the VGS2. Can I say that this VGS2 is nothing but the voltage between G2 and ground, right? Now the same voltage I am getting from D1 and ground. So I can say that this VGS2 is nothing but VO1. Great. So that is nothing but the value of voltage gain for second stage. That is nothing but AV2. Right. So I can say that AV2 is nothing but minus GM2 multiplied by RD2. Simple. Now let's proceed further. I want to move from VO1 to VI. Okay. So in between, I will be getting the value, let's say VX. Okay. So let's try to figure out again the same methodology we will apply to calculate the value of first stage ka voltage gain. Okay. So first stage ka voltage gain is nothing but, let's say I want to take the ratio of VO1 divided by, first I will take the value of, let's say, VI. VO1 divided by VI is AV1. Okay. And that VO1 divided by VI, again I will split into two parts. One is VO1 divided by VX multiplied by VX divided by VI. Simple. So VO1 divided by VX into VX divided by VI, that will give you simplified version for your first stage ka voltage gain. So let's try to say, find out the value of VO1 divided by VX. Again, we will apply KCL at node B this time, and where I want to find, I want to place this node B. Let's see, this node B is nothing but this is your node B. Okay, where we have to find out, where we'll have to apply the KCL. Okay, so let us see how we will proceed. How many currents are there which are flowing? Can I say that RD1, RG1 placed in parallel to each other, because RD1 is also connected to the ground, RG1 is also connected to the ground. So these forms your parallel combination. I can say that one current is flowing here, one current is flowing here, and another current is flowing here. This is your open circuit, right? So basically, this two parallel combination combined resistance ka current and this particular current, these all currents are outgoing current. So outgoing current is equal to incoming current. So I will be getting the equation like this. Let's say GM1 into VGS1 plus, I can say that combined resistance will be RD1 parallel RG2, right? And uska inverse multiplied by the value of VO1 is equal to 0. You're getting what I'm trying to do? This is nothing but the current flowing through parallel combination of RD1 and RG2. Because this value of voltage VO1, that is nothing but VGS2. So VO1 or VGS2 divided by RD1 parallel RG2. So I can say that whatever ratio I am getting, that is nothing but VO1 to VGS1. And if you see this particular circuit very seriously, this VGS1 is nothing but the value of VX. So we have got the first ratio, that is nothing but VO1 from this equation itself. Okay. So whatever equation we have got, that is nothing but, let's say, VO1 divided by VGS1 is equal to VGS2, because VO1 itself is a VGS2. VGS2 divided by VGS1, right? And that is equal to minus GM1 multiplied by RD1 parallel RG2. Okay, I can treat this as equation number 2. Okay, the first equation, we'll just have a look at the first equation. First equation was VO divided by VGS2, and second equation we have got VGS2 divided by VGS1. Now if you note that from this particular AC equivalent circuit, we will be getting that we are started from VO, we reach towards VGS2, and now we reach towards the value of VGS1. Oh great, that is nothing but the value of VX. Okay, so far we just have to reach from VX to VI, right? So equation number 2 tells you that we reached from VO to VX. Okay, so I'll say that this is nothing but the value VGS2 divided by VX. Okay, now we have to find out what is the value of VX divided by VI, right? Here we have to apply voltage divider rule. Apply VDR for circuit at input of stage 1. Okay, as far as applying VDR for circuit at input of stage 1 is concerned, we'll draw this circuit over here. This is your R, that is nothing but not R, it's source resistance, that is R signal, and here we will be getting the value Vx, right? And here my value, expected value to reach, that is Vi. Okay, here we have the resistance, that is nothing but Rg1. Okay, so that is also connected to ground. I just want to find out the ratio between Vx and Vi. We'll apply the value, we'll apply the VDR, that is one of the five fingers law. I can say that this Vx will become, what will be the value of Vx? Yes, Vx will become, Vx is Rg1 divided by Rg1 plus R signal multiplied by the total input, that is total voltage, that is nothing but Vi. I can get the value Vx divided by Vi is nothing but, I will take this over here, right? And I will be getting Rg1 divided by Rg1 plus R signal, and that is nothing but equation number 3. Okay, so from combining all the three equations, we will be getting the total gain of multistage amplifier, that is nothing but, we will say that voltage gain is equal to AV is equal to AV1 multiplied by AV2. I can say that this is nothing but VO divided by VO1 multiplied by VO1 divided by Vx multiplied by Vx divided by Vi. Okay, as far as Vx divided by Vi is concerned, it is nearly equal to 1. This is because input resistance, gate resistance of first stage, gate resistance of JFET is always and always very, very high. If gate resistance is very, very high, then Rg divided by Rg plus R signal, that will be tending towards 1 only. Okay, so let's try to get all these values in a combined format. So that we'll be getting, this is nothing but Gm2 multiplied by Rd2, right? If RL is given, you have to consider Rd2 parallel with RL, okay? Multiplied by minus of Gm1 with Rd1 parallel with Rg2, okay? And in a combined form, I can say Vx divided by Vi is nothing but Rg1 divided by Rg1 plus R signal, okay? As this value is tending towards 1, I can say that this value is tending towards 1. I can say this combined form will be getting this, that is nothing but minus minus will come plus. I will be getting Gm1 into Gm2 into Rd2 into Rd1 parallel Rg2. Again, here we have to consider if load resistance is given, then Rd2 in parallel with RL, right? So that is nothing but the value of AV I am getting, okay? So this is nothing but the value of AV along with the source resistance. This is nothing but the value of AV along with, without consideration of source resistance. If we are considering the value of RL, then we can say that AVL will become Gm1, Gm2, with Rd2 in parallel with RL and Rd1 in parallel with Rg2, right? If load resistance is given, okay? This is not given in this circuit right now, but if they ask us to find out the voltage gain with load resistance, then this picture should be clear to you, okay? So as far as voltage gain is concerned, it is done for mathematical AC analysis, okay? Now let's come to the, again, the AC equivalent model to find out the input resistance and output resistance. From here itself, we'll find out what will be the input resistance and what will be the output resistance for two-stage JFET amplifier. From here, we have to find out what will be the value of input resistance. So as far as JFET is concerned, this is open circuit, so I will be getting only one resistance, that is nothing but your input resistance, let's say Ri is equal to Rg1, okay? When I'm looking at the input side, then I'm getting that Rs, R signal plus Ri, that is equal to your Zi, okay? So Zi is nothing but under consideration of the source resistance that you have to add along with your Rg. As I cleared earlier, RG is very, very high as compared to R signal, I can also treat this input resistance, input impedance, same as that of your RI, that is nothing but RG1. So as far as input stage of complete operation, complete multi-stage amplifier is concerned, we have got the input resistance. Now, to deal with the output resistance, we just have to take this particular output side. We just want to look from the output side. We are getting that RO is equal to RD2, right? Now here again I will say that if RL is given, then I can say that the value of RO will become RD2 in parallel with RL. Okay, so with load resistance, your output impedance will decrease. And this is the effect of load resistance that you have to understand. Okay, if I'm considering the source resistance, then your input impedance increases, but not up to that much extent as far as JFET is concerned. So this is your input impedance, this is your output impedance and voltage gain that you have to calculate as far as AC analysis is concerned. So this is all about your two-stage CS-CS amplifier AC analysis, where we have calculated voltage gain, input impedance, output impedance and the required parameter from DC analysis. So learn more and more EDC2 with me with Ikeda videos. We'll enjoy with EDC2. Thank you so much.